Well, pretty soon these desks will be full of kids again. We're not ending summer, but it's a good time to think about those back-to-school gadgets, even though it's not quite here yet. Your kids might need, for the school year, they might need stuff you didn't think of yet.
Michael Sheehan is the high-tech dad. He maintains a blog full of good stuff, including product reviews from the perspective of a parent. He joins us from the San Francisco area. Good morning.
Good morning, Robin and Larry. How are you guys?
Good. Good to have you with us. So a few tips before we get started. You say we should update a cable or DSL modem. Why should we do that? Is there any particular kind that we should be looking at?
Not really. I mean, my recommendations tend to focus on more of the families of products. So anytime you want to upgrade to a faster speed or something like that, there's some new standards that come out, particularly around cable modems. You want to get the fastest speeds possible for when your kids are online supposedly doing their homework.
And what about if people are trying to choose between, you know, a different laptop? Should you get them the most expensive kind? Is that going to be easiest? Or what do you recommend as a parent?
I usually say something right around in the middle of the road is usually good. You don't want to buy the cheapest thing out there because you're going to regret it later. It may not perform as quickly as possible. The battery may not last as long as you want. And then unless you're doing some extreme gaming, which, you know, we're supposed to be talking about back to school here, you don't need the most high-end laptop or tablet out there. So I always say right around the middle of the road is usually good.
And you say rechargeable battery packs for laptops and so forth, which I imagine are extra. They don't come with the laptop that you get.
Yeah, either for the laptop or more around using a smartphone or tablet. My kids love stealing my portable rechargeable batteries so they can have their phones always sort of tethered to a power source. So they really like stealing those for me. So I recommend those highly.
I'm curious what you think of this whole Pokemon Go craze. You think you should let your kids do it?
Well, I mean, if you're going to do that, you better get it out of your system before school starts. I wouldn't be surprised if schools are going to ban the playing of Pokemon Go. I personally have tried it out. My wife has tried it out. My kids don't have enough space on their devices to put it on, but we did actually go out for a walk in the neighborhood together as a family and play around with it and learn what it was all about, and hopefully that got it out of their system.
How do you manage your kids' screen time, laptop, etc.? Is it free range, or do you have parameters, and what are they?
Well, it is tricky. I mean, we do have a set rule where the devices, particularly cell phones, have to go into our bedroom for charging. We actually have modified a little book safe where I drilled some holes in it and put charging cables in there, and they put their devices in there, and we can lock it up if we want to. But our main rule is no devices at night when it's time to sleep. And we get it out of their rooms. I mean, that's the most important thing. But it's important to remember each family is different. You really have to figure out your family dynamics and regulate it that way. And just talk to your kids about, you know, the importance of putting the gadget away occasionally.
Real quickly, what age do you get your kids' phones?
It seems like each year it gets younger and younger. I mean, I have three daughters, and the youngest got one a lot earlier than my oldest did. So, again, it's kind of up to the family and how you're going to regulate that.
All right. You can find Michael on his site, hightechdad.com. Thanks, Michael.